Hey guys, and welcome to part three, which is how we put them both together. So how do we flow from pronation to supination and create an exercise that's a little bit more functional? We're going to start with one of the basic check-ins that we look at in clinic and that I use in my classes here in Sydney. So just start in parallel, and you can either use your pelvis as the driver, so rotating right and left, or if you want to, you can work with your arms as a driver, rotating at shoulder height, right and left. What you want to feel for in your feet is that foot dance. So I rotate this way, I have supination right, pronation left. And they mirror together, and I'm looking for the same ease, quality, and timing of my movement. Can I keep my tripod fully connected on the floor? Do I have external and internal rotation? My next exercise is to drive the body from a full spectrum, from pronation all the way through to supination. Pronate, supinate. One end of the spectrum to the other, back and forth, back and forth. So, using my right leg here, I'm going to rotate in and come down. Now again, just note my weight is right over the foot. I'm then going to rotate, drive forward with my knee, and that's going to rotate this leg into supination. Bend, straighten, internal, external. Tripod is on the floor the whole time. Looking closer at this motion. In, out, in, out. Just watch for hyperextended knees with this. It wants to be in neutral, not resting back. The pelvis will tilt forwards, the pelvis tilts under a little bit. And we have nice rhythmic motion. Just look again, guys, at how much my knee actually tilts in. I get my leg out of the way. And that's okay, that's healthy, that's me loading. As long as I can get out of it again. Some of these problems and misconceptions with pronation are because you can't get out of the pronated position again, and that's where you're living. So that will cause problems within the body and tracking all the way up to the head. The previous drill can be done with more of a plie and rise combination. So I'm going to fondue, allow my foot to pronate, come up into a rise, and then twist around in the opposite direction so I get full supination. Rhythmic. Pronate, supinate, pronate, supinate. From more front on angle, pronate, supinate, pronate, supinate. Land for my jump on a mobile adapter, come up and rise, weight bear on a rigid lever. This next drill is also for pronation, supination, a little bit more dynamic and flowing. Now I can work it in parallel, split stance, and I'm going to drive the arm in. Drive the arm up. This foot is pronating, supinating, pronating, supinating. Driven by the whole body. So I get the ankle, leg, pelvis, thorax, and then coming in, I get the ankle, the triple flexion, ankle, knee, hip, center of mass the whole time, staying over the foot. This can be made a little bit more classical if you want to. Turn out, come in, come out, come in, come out, come in, come out. And then you get that nice backwards and forwards motion of the foot, training from one end of the spectrum to the other, loading and unloading. I hope these drills will help, and you can use them in your warm-ups, prehab, or maybe even in your classes. legs need to come in. You need to lengthen your glutes. Stretching, harness the power so that you can shorten and jump. And this is exactly the same when you work in turnout. You need to bend, load, allow the arch to lengthen. The knees will come in of the feet a little bit. Your turnout is still controlled from here. Don't get me wrong. We still don't want to see that motion or 2 feet looking different. That's asymmetry, not something that we're looking for. We're looking for good timing and control. Coming in, coming out, out, out. Internal, center. If you supinate, you'll come out a little bit. If you're working with that type 2 supination that I mentioned, so you're rotating, if you continue that motion, it will automatically bring you up into extension anyway, because that's the way that the body likes to move. Supination ideally is with a straight knee, a straight hip, and a more plantar flexed ankle. I hope you've enjoyed this 3-part series and learnt a little bit more about your feet. Don't forget, subscribe, check in, lots more information coming your way. Don't forget, before any of your rehab, you can always do some myofascial releases into the underside of your foot. I've got plenty of videos on my Mobility Monday playlist channel that give you great advice on how to loosen up foot and calf area that you can do prior to doing these pronation drills or supination drills.